got to tell you, I'm very excited to be here. I've had a great week. I just got an electric car. Sweet. It is sweet. It's in the shop now. We're having a gas engine put in it, but I love it. Oh, it is the best. It's so unique, you know? I just missed gassing up my car. And, you know, petroleum now, the gas prices are coming down so much. But they'll go back up again. It's all confusing. And I don't get it because I was in the pharmacy a couple days ago. I saw that petroleum jelly has not gone up 1 cent. Too bad our car is going to run on petroleum jelly. That would be pretty cool. Be hard to get it in there, though, but you get it in there. You work it in there. You work it in. You do what you got to do. You know what I'm saying? But I'm telling you, this thing is a babe magnet, which I don't need because I've been married for the last 13 years. But I still like the look, though. I'll tell you that. I'll be honest with you. I got a wandering eye. But luckily, my other eye is a lazy eye. So it's a push. They cancel each other out. The wandering eye is like, hey, baby, why don't you go back to my place and have a little drink? And then the lazy eye comes around. Oh, this looks like a lot of work. Let's just have a cookie, huh? Somebody asked me last week what my best pickup line was. And, you know, like I said, I've been married for the last 13 years. So my best pickup line is, hey, are you awake? Right? Anyway, so you guys can follow me on Twitter or on Amber Alert. Those two things right there. My Twitter is at Kevin_Nealon, and my Amber Alert, it's a blue El Camino Nevada license plates. So anyway, this year I've decided I would like to take more risks in life. And by risks, I'm talking about trying new restaurants. There is a restaurant in my neighborhood, a Korean restaurant, and I've been going by this place for the last 6 years. I never tried it. And 2 weeks ago I said, you know what, I'm gonna give it a shot. And I did, and guess what? Horrible, horrible food. I think it's a nail salon during the day or something, I don't know. But not good, not good. But you know what, I'm trying new foods. I have a friend that doesn't try new foods, eats the same food every day, pretty much. I don't think he's ever had Italian food. It's odd. I mean, he also doesn't, he thinks he can't get a disease if he hasn't heard of it. I see. Sometimes when we're in an argument, and I'm, you know, angry at him, I'll just start yelling out rare diseases. You're like, diverticulitis, fibromyalgia. And if I can't think of a rare disease, I'll yell at an Italian dish. You know, he doesn't know. Penne arrabbiata. He thinks it's a rare disease. Bruschetta. He's confined to his house right now with the deadly fusilli bolognese. I'm not kidding around. He called his doctor. He said, what should I do for fusilli bolognese? The doctor said, just, you know, boil some water. Throw it in there. But you know what? Everyone's got their own fears. We all have our own fears. Mine for a long time, and it doesn't have to be rational. Mine was sharks for a long time. But no more. Now, chimpanzees. Have you read about these chimpanzee attacks? They rip your face off. And go for the crotch. I'm not talking about the cute little chimpanzee with the sweater vest and the suspenders. That's Larry King. I'm talking, no. I'm talking about the big strength of four grown men chimpanzees. Four grown men. That's the number they come up with all the time. It's four grown men. They must have done a study at one point, you know, to figure that out. They start with one grown man. You know, get in the cage with that chimp. Let's see who's stronger. Oh, no, two grown men. Three. Until they get to four. It cost six lives, that study. But it's worth it. They got their answer. It's four. But at least with a shark attack, there's no drama. You know, it just pulls you down. There's no mess. You're like, hey, you know, you're gone. Your friends don't even know it. They're like on the beach, you know, where's Kevin? I think he's at the snack bar. Throw him the frisbee. But with the chimpanzee attack, can you imagine the horror? It probably sneaks up behind you, like on one of those little tricycles. And I'm telling you, the last minute, that horn on the handlebar, hey, they turn around, face. And crotch. They get your jaw so that you can't bite them. That's what they do. And then they go for the crotch. But seriously, who wants to have sex at this point? Not me. Because like I said, I've been married for the last 13 years. Thank you very much. Thank you.